All right, so what are the pros and cons of using LCD display? So when I'm comparing these pros and cons, I'm really what I'm comparing it against is this other competing technology, which is called OLED or organic light emitting diodes. And when I compare my LCD displays versus OLEDs, so the first thing, the very first thing that I notice is that LCD displays, if I buy them in market, are much more cheaper. So if you go in Fry's and you try to buy a TV, almost all of them would be LCD, and you could buy them at you can buy easily buy a 32-inch LCD for less than $400. And if you would, first of all, you'll have very difficult time finding these OLED displays, and even if you find them, they'll cost you more than 3 or 4,000 grand for a similar size as the LCD display. So as compared to OLEDs, LCDs are definitely low cost, and that has resulted from a fact that it's a very mature technology. People have been using it, and they have been manufacturing it for over two decades now. So that has really brought down the cost, and it's a really low cost technology. Secondly, is the other important thing is that as compared to OLEDs, you get higher resolution in LCD. At the moment, you can very easily buy LCD which have resolution of over 300 pixel per inch, and this is what Apple likes to call it. That over 300 is what you call as retina display if you hold it 10 inch away from your eye. And as compared to that, OLEDs currently have resolution of approaching or less than 300 pixel per inch. So they have, at the moment, LCDs have higher display, higher resolution as compared to OLEDs. Another, at the moment, also they have higher brightness, so you can easily get very high brightness LCD display. And the reason they achieve that, even though the process of getting light through this many layers is very inefficient, you can get very bright backlight. So you can, there's no limit to how bright a backlight you can get. And currently in market, you can buy displays which have, I know Nokia has one which has a brightness of over 1,000 candela per meter square. So currently you can buy these with very high brightness, even though they are not very efficient, but nobody complains about these displays being less bright, because you can essentially make your backlight as bright as you want. One of now, so these are the pros. Now, let's do a fair comparison and let's look at all the drawbacks. So one of the main drawbacks, or one of the compromises that you get is that whenever you want to make these colors of these you want to increase the color gamut of your LCD, there's a trade-off that which always occur, that is your color gamut versus your brightness always have a trade-off. So the way you can increase these color gamut of these LCD displays, you can make these RGB filters more strong or more saturated, and that would give you a higher color gamut. But that comes at the expense that each of these filters, now they are more strong, they only let even marginal amount of light through them, so they decrease the overall brightness of your display. So this color gamut increase is achieved at the expense of reducing your brightness in your LCD display. Another disadvantage of these LCD displays, your backlight always has to be on. So even when you want to generate black, your backlight has to be on, and you essentially, the way you generate black is reject turn each of these RGB pixels off, and but still you're, even if you have a very black image, like, you know, something like which is your the sketchboard that I use, that, you know, which is mostly has a black background, your backlight will always be on. And especially if you are generating, you know, if you have an image which is mostly black, you still are using a lot of you're still consuming a lot of power to display it. Another thing which I already which is that these the contrast in these LCD display is limited to, you know, something around 1000 to 1, and that comes from the fact that there's always some light which leaks through. So there's always some light which leaks through, and there's especially when you want to turn the pixel off, or you want to display a black thing, that's always not black, so it's more like a gray black, and that limits your overall contrast, because, you know, you cannot completely turn the pixel off, so your black is never 100% blacks, and that limits your overall contrast to less than 1000 to 1. And the biggest limitation, or, you know, the biggest drawback comes from this fact that you have these many layers in a LCD display, and each of these limits your efficiency. So you get less than 5% efficiency of your photons from your backlight which pass through, and the backlight also has the efficiency of, you know, if it's a LED, it has the efficiency of, you know, 20 to 30%. So overall, converting your light into how many photons that come out, it has, you know, your LCD based display have an efficiency of 1 to 2%, and having these many layers, it also limits your viewing angle. So passing lights through this many layers, when it finally comes out, it is very directional, so that limits your viewing angle, and that is shown in more detail in this picture over here. So this plots essentially the contrast for a LCD cell, and as you can see, you have a contrast, a very high contrast at when you're viewing it at an angle of zero. So when you're viewing it at a normal angle, you get this contrast of 800 to 1, that I you know, around 1000, that's the maximum contrast you get. But if you tilt your display, if you view it at an angle, this contrast falls at a very sharp rate. So even if you view it at, you know, an angle of 20 degree from the normal, you already have decreased your contrast from 800 to 400. And if you view it at a 60 degree angle, you get a contrast of only 10:1. And that's, you know, that's something that even your human eye has a very hard time distinguishing. So the quality of this LCD display, or the quality of the image, it falls very sharply as you increase your viewing angle. So this one of the latest developments that has taken place in the field of LCD is motivated by improving this viewing angle, and it's called in-plane switching display. So to describe that, you know, I'm describing these two different schemes that are used, that you can use to control your liquid crystal. So the most common scheme is the twisted Nematic scheme, which essentially means that you have these two transparent conducting electrodes, and these are perpendicular to each other, and, you know, you could not apply a voltage and they would be letting the liquid crystal will let the light through, or you could apply a voltage over here and the liquid crystal won't let any light through. But these two electrodes which are controlling your liquid crystal, they are placed in, you know, on the two sides of the liquid crystal, and That's the standard configuration which was used for many years, and it's called a twisted pneumatic configuration or a TN configuration. One of the limitations of this is that your light has to pass through this electrode, and it has to pass through this other transparent electrode, and you have essentially more layers. You add more layers to your liquid crystal display. Another thing is that if you add a touch screen on the top and you apply some pressure, so some of that, you know, passes through, that pressure comes through your liquid crystal as well, and when you touch this top or you modulate this size or volume of this liquid crystal, it results in this thing called a tail. When you say, you know, if you have a LCD monitor, try, you know, touching it from the top, and you see this tail of or you know this phenomena called a tail, which occurs when you press these LCD display on your monitors and you apply a pressure on them. So one of the latest developments that has taken place in the field of LCD display is that people have adopted this new technology called in-plane switching. So instead of having those two electrodes on the top and the bottom, you have these two electrodes placed side by side, and they apply an electric field like this, which bends your liquid crystal molecules, and you know you can control the liquid crystal orientation by now having an electric field which is in the plane instead of having perpendicular to the plane. And that reduces, what it does is it reduces one, now you have, you know, a few layers less, you don't have that other conducting electrode placed on the top, so you have less number of layers. A disadvantage is that now you have more of your area occupied by these electrodes, so you degrade your fill factor slightly, but you have less of these layers on the top. Also, you don't have that transparent conducting electrode on the top, so if you press it from the top, now you don't get any tail in your viewing. So one of the advantage that you get is pointed out in this figure. So now that you have you have less number of layers, so you get a better viewing angle. So this picture over here, it compares the viewing angle between your IPS and your twisted pneumatic. So you can see that for your twisted pneumatic kind of configuration, your contrast falls off very sharply, and you get a very small viewing angle of less than 20 degree on each side. Versus if you use the IPS technology, now you have less number of layers, so you get a much larger viewing angle. And you know, for more, especially this removal of this tail on the top, it's especially even more important for your smartphones and your tablets. So this was the IPS technology is very commonly used in your smartphones and your tablets, which use these LCD based displays. And you know, you can see this announcement from iPhone 4 keynote, and you know, Steve Jobs is saying that, you know, they're using this, they're switching for this IPS or in-plane switching technology, and that helps them achieving a wider viewing angle.